So we've received a lot of leaks and data mined information about unreleased content for Dragon Ball Z Kakarot, but one thing people keep hoping for is the inclusion of content from Dragon Ball GT. Now GT is a little trickier to add to the game than other requests like arcs from Dragon Ball Super and content from Dragon Ball Z movies. This is because Dragon Ball GT is not a part of the main continuity for Dragon Ball and is not canon. Now with that said, yes, there is plenty of non-canon characters and content already in the game, like Mira, Toa, and Android 21, and the developers have said they plan on creating original stories, so the status of canon doesn't really matter. But most things that are non-canon can still fit in the story, like the Otherworld Tournament exists in the Datamine files, but the Otherworld Tournament can still fit into the game's narrative, and so can Dragon Ball Z movies. But since there is Dragon Ball Super content also data mined to be in the game, that automatically makes GT harder to fit into the story. With that said, there is still some evidence that supports GT's inclusion. Like I said in other videos, there is a line of dialogue in the game's files that mentions Broly, and this line of dialogue does not fit the Dragon Ball Super version of Broly because it talks about using Dragon Balls to take Broly down. Now the Dragon Ball Super Broly was saved by the Dragon Balls, but in Dragon Ball Z, Goten did have the Dragon Balls used in order to take Broly down. So this means we could be getting the original Broly. But why does this help the chances for GT? Well, because in the files there also exists renders for Super Saiyan God Vegeta. And the only time we ever saw Vegeta turn into a Super Saiyan God was in Dragon Ball Super Broly. Therefore, we could be getting both Dragon Ball Z Broly and Dragon Ball Super Broly, which makes sense because Broly makes them a lot of money, so the more Broly DLC they can make, the better for them. But these two Brolys exist in two different continuities, and GT and Super also exist in two different continuities, which means if we get two Brolys, then we could get two Dragon Ball Z sequels, which are Super and GT. As we speak, we are allowed to move through time within the game, so it's not much of a stretch to move through continuities also. Xenoverse also figured out a way to have both by having Super in the main story and GT in the extra missions, so I would say GT is completely plausible for DLC in Dragon Ball Z Kakarot. Let me know what you guys think. I want to thank you guys for watching. My name's Konjic, and I'll talk to you in the next video.